Hello, in this video I'm quickly going to show you or demonstrate you the tool that we're going to build in the lesson walkthrough, the tool for querying different services on the web to create point features and then add them either to an open layer in ArcGIS, to a shapefile on disk, or just to a CSV text file. And well, you can see the tool here on the right on the screen. I'm currently running it inside of ArcGIS Pro, and I've already used it to add a few places for different attractions in Paris. And well, the GUI is structured into four different parts. We have a part at the top where the user can enter a query term, a name of a place. Then we have an area where he can choose between different web services to query. Then an area where he will see the result of this query, and then an area where he can add the features he wants to some data source. So let's demonstrate this by querying for Eiffel Tower. And I'm going to use the Nominatum query interface to OpenStreetMap. I'm not going to use any of the options for this first query. Just click the Run Query button. And you see that then the result list here is updated based on what we get back from this Nominatum web service. And we have this nice little web map widget here on the right that shows us the different results on a map, which can also be very handy. Obviously, we are interested in the one here that is located in Paris. So we can actually click on that one and then see, okay, this is the one called Eiffel Tower. So basically the third one here from our list. So what I can do is use the buttons below the results to clear the selection and then say, I just want this entry here. And here at the bottom, you can see that I'm currently on the tab for adding the features to a layer in ArcGIS Pro. And I've selected the Paris example layer that I set up for this project, and the names of the features should be stored in the field called name of that layer. So I would just click the add button now to add this one feature for the Eiffel Tower to this data set. And actually for having it show up on the map, I need to zoom in and zoom out a bit so that the map gets updated. And then you see here now that this new point has been added. And well, just to show you the rest of the interface, we have another tab here for, instead of Nominatum, querying the GeoNames web service with different options for that. And we have also a tab that allows us for directly entering features with name, latitude, and longitude. So let's say I have created this map for a friend, and now I also want to at my home as a place to that map. I could enter it here, my home, and then I would have to enter some coordinates. So let's hope that I'm going to find something that is at least somehow in the area of Paris. Okay, it's still, the button is still running, called Run Query, but in principle it just creates a single point feature from what I entered here that is shown here in the list. It looks like I actually at least hit a place somewhere in Paris. And I can now also add that one to the layer here. So I'm not sure which one is the new place. I think it's the one up here, that one here. So that's now, I can click on it. Yes, it's the place, my home. So you see now that the result has indeed been added to the layer. And just to look at the last tabs here. So the shapefile tab would allow us to instead add the features to a shapefile on disk. And there's also the option to create a new shapefile for that purpose that opens a separate dialog box for which you also will have to create the graphical user interface. And the last one is the CSV tab, where we just can select a file to which the features will be added as, well, basically name, latitude, longitude columns, and the buttons with the three dots on it are always for opening a file dialog for selecting a particular shapefile or CSV file. Okay, so much for this overview, and now we will move on and actually create the graphical user interface for this tool.